my kitchen, and today we're gonna talk about board. How important it is to cover your board. It's nothing worse than to see these beautiful cakes on a silver board. Take your time, you know, look after your board, cover with fondant, or I'm gonna show you a couple of options in here that it will save you time too and money. My cakes is not usually in contact direct with the board because there is a structure holding the cake up. Like if it is motorbike, I didn't have to go to the trouble to cover the board with fondant like that. It's also a very nice technique that I'm going to show very soon. Structure cake is special. You can even paint with acrylic paint, spray paint, so you get a very nice coverage, and you just paint. That will save you a lot of money because with one of these babies you can spray a lot of boards. You could cover with contact paper, and contact paper is used for cover kids' school books. I love contact paper. I love contact paper because it's easy to clean. You just wipe and it cleans the surface. It's cheap. For $2 a roll, you can cover at least 3 boards. So it's a great option too. And contact paper, you could even cover the sides of your board too in one go. Big fan of contact paper. Every time I travel around doing my classes, I always cover my boards with contact paper because these days you have that many options. Look, you can buy great, you know, finish, and there is some with texture. Absolutely love contact paper, and when you start using contact paper, very rare you go back into the fondant because fondant does take more time. But what I love about the fondant is what you can create on your board, you know, and it almost becomes part of the cake. And when you look a board like that, you almost think that the board is edible, that you can pick it up, eat the board. It's a little bit more expensive, yes, but also looks really, really good. All right, and look how many techniques you can do to your board with very simple pressure mats. This one is for a scrapbook. I have these ones that is from CK. It's Impression Max animal prints, and I love these ones because although they are animal prints, I use it for completely different purpose. I pretend that is a road, that is wood, that is the bottom of the ocean. So you can create so many different things with these impression mats, and they are really cheap. And the best part is that a lot of people don't know there is two sides of the impression mat. So if you push the impression mat down, you get the impression inside of your fondant, so you get this ridge is really beautiful like in here. But if you change the position and put up, you end up with all this texture on your fondant that is magical, you know, and you can touch and you can see it. So I'm a big fan of a impression mat, and I will just show you how easy it is to use impression mat and fondant on your board. Let's cover this board. I like to use Tylus glue to make sticky, and I put a little bit of Tylus glue all over the board. You can use your brush if you want, but I do like to use my hands and spread all, because then I know it spreads everywhere. I know you're gonna ask me, what is Tylus glue? It's just CMC with water. And then I put inside the pot and I shake. And I really like to leave overnight actually, because then it gets nice and thick like that, almost like a gelatin. And it's really, it sticks anything. And what I like is it dries faster too, really, really fast. So I open my fondant, and I will put my fondant on the board, stretch on the board, just like that. Ta-da! And there's the smoothness. This is my kitchen, alright? That is real life for you in here. There is no other way to explain this, but it's improvisation and doing as I do every day. So I cover my board, my pretty board, and you can use any impression mat you want. I have these really nice ones by Cake Stamps. Thank you very much. I really like them. They have really nice designs in here that is really cute. Even scrapbook ones, you know, the ones that come for free on a magazine, you can use this really nice. But I'm going to show you how to make something like that. So I'm going to put the image down, and I push with my smoother so I can get the impression really nice. And you have to be careful not to move the impression matter too much, because then you lose the design. It's like I just did it, you know, I move it too much. This is how easy it is, all right? You just push and put a lot of pressure there and you get a really nice impression. So like I said to you, I really like to leave this set overnight, but because I wanted to show you really quick how I do the painting around. So now I'm going to get black, airbrush black, and I'm going to spray all my board. I'm trying to go inside the spaces like that, and then using wipers, any cloth that is a little bit wet with a little bit of alcohol, and then I just go and clean what I spray. So of course you can take as much as you want from this. It's up to you how dirty you want your roads to look. As you can see in here, I really removed a lot of the painting. So it's up to you how much you're gonna remove. You see, the more you take it, the more effective it look, you know. I'm trying to do always the same stroke. So you're going in one direction and let it dry, although when it's still wet like that, you can sprinkle some shimmer. You can even add a different color on your road in here and make your road look a little bit multi. It's up to you how far you're gonna go with this decoration, but like I said, when it's still wet like that, you can sprinkle some sparkle. This is another thing that I absolutely love. How cool is that? Before I used to blow with my hands, and now I can just use one of those, and look at that, perfect cover. It looks absolute awesome, and when you put this on a cake, it looks fantastic. It gives a beautiful effect. Final step, a cake should always have a rib around the board. Should never show the silver board like that. So I always start from the back, little bit of a hot glue. And that's why I love this hot glue gun from Bosch, because you have this very point needle there, so you can go straight where the board is, not touching the cake. And then I go and I just put the hot glue around. So be careful, it's very hot. And go around. And voila! Now come in here, Remy! Come in here, my media advertiser promoter. She's the one setting up all that, and she goes over all my videos and she remake and prepare everything for you at home to watch. And this cake is for you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. She absolutely loves it. So happy birthday, Remy, and thank you very much for everything. Now everybody home knows you. Thank you very much. Keep following. So next week I'm gonna show you how to make silicone molds and molds with leftover fondant. Thank you so much. Bye.